Okay, this is the second video in a series on the very basics of Babylon.js, creating 3D environments and games inside your web browser using JavaScript and HTML5. Here is the basic scene that we created last week in the first tutorial. Hopefully you've watched it because it went over a lot of the basics. We got a basic camera that arcs around the center point of our scene. We got a few basic meshes here, a plane that's only one side, that's why it's invisible from this side, and one light element off here to light, which is a basic point light. So let's go ahead and start where we left off last week. And I'm going to, I renamed the file to 2, excuse me. And so let's start off by working with the scaling and rotation. Last week we looked at positioning of the objects. Let's look this week at scaling them and rotating them. So our first object was our sphere, our ball object. So let's go ahead and come in here right after we created it. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take it and I'm going to scale it. I'm going to stretch it on its y-axis, which in Babylon.js, y is up and down. So I'm going to say ball because that's the object we're working with. I'm going to say scaling.y. I'm going to say it equals 2, so that will double the length of it up and down. Let's go ahead and save that. And we will refresh here, watch the sphere here. You can see it looks stretched out now because we stretched it on its y-axis. And let's keep moving. I will take our box object and we can rotate it if we want. And so I'll say box dot rotation. And I will say, let's rotate it on the x-axis. And now we can give it a number. We can say, you know, 10, 20, whatever, but let's move it from where it's at a certain amount rather than set it to a set position. So I'll say plus equals, so it's whatever it already equals at the x, its x rotation, and we'll add 1 to it. Let's see how that looks. So watch the sphere over here to the right, and you can see now it's been rotated one unit. Let's go back here and let's move it 0.1, save that, and you'll see that it's rotated. It's almost non-visible, it just rotated a little bit. But let's take that, and instead of putting it up here where we're creating stuff, let's put it down here in our render loop. Again, this is where the function that has it continuously, every time it renders, it will run this function. And let's go ahead and paste that in there. So what it's going to do now is, every time the scene renders, it's going to take the box, look at its position, and move it 0.0 units more on the x-axis. So save that, come back here, hit F5, and you can see it rotating. Do want to take into account, this may not always be the best way to do it in all situations, because depending on the speed of your computer, depends on how fast and how often it renders, and will affect how fast the box rotates. So you might want to use some other timing mechanism, but for a very basic rotation, there you have it. And if we want, we can get going on another axis as well. So let's go back into our code here. I'm just going to copy and paste that line and change the next line to the y-axis. So now it will rotate 0.01 more units on the y-axis. So we'll save that. I'll hit F5, and there you go. You can see, you saw it running a little slow while the scene was still loading, but we have it rotating in two directions now. Let's do the same for our cylinder over here to the left. We'll come in here and we will put it down again in our render loop here. So if you want to just move to a certain position, you can put it someplace else, but since we're going to be looping this, we'll put it down here. We'll say cylinder, which is our object that we created up here. We'll say dot rotation dot x, and we'll say its current position plus, or we can go minus if we want it to go the other direction, 0.1. We'll hit F5, and there you go, it's rotating now from this angle. it's rotating clockwise. If we did a positive number, it would be rotating counterclockwise. Then again, that's all based on what side you're looking at it from. So that's basic rotation and scaling. And we looked at a little bit of rotation last with this plane, because we did rotate the plane by pi, which rotated 180 degrees. We rotated on its y-axis. And I could stop the tutorial there, but I felt like that wasn't enough for a full tutorial. It was really short. So let's play around with our lighting a little bit. We have one light element up here. We called it light 0. It is a point light, and we gave it a position of 10, which moved it forward in our scene. Let's go ahead and work and play around with its coloring. So what we're going to do here is, let's go ahead and look at our scene here. Now you notice we have it, it's by default a white light. Our planes don't really have any colors, kind of a default grayish, whitish color. If you've worked with coloring in 3D, or really coloring with any type of 3D-like object, you might be familiar with diffusion and specularity. Basically, your diffusion is basically the diffused light out here, and the specularity is this shininess right here, this little point. You can see it on the sphere there, you can see it on the plane here, the cube, and there you can see some specularity on the cylinder there as it rotates. And we can set different colors for each of those. So let's go ahead and do that. So we're going to go up, we'll do it right below where we created the light just to keep things close. So we're going to say take the light 0 object, which we created there, we called it light 0. And let's go ahead and affect its diffuse. We're going to set it to a value, we're going to say a new value, and we're going to use our Babylon JavaScript to create this, and we're going to create a new Babylon color 3, which is going to be an RGB, which is red, green, and blue. So I can say 0, 1, 0, and the values go from 0 to 1, 1 being the strongest. Might be a little confusing because in many cases it goes from 0 to 155. So anything in between, completely removing the color and having the color full, will be a decimal point. So we have 0 red, 100% green, and 0% blue. So basically, right now we're going to have a pure green light. Hit F5, and there you go. You can see that we have green. We haven't changed the color of the objects. We've changed the color of the light shining on them. Our specularity is still white, so let's go ahead and give our specularity a different color. To save time, I'm just going to copy and paste this line we just created for that, and I'm going to change this to stay, instead of diffuse, we're going to say specular. And it's still set to a value of green. Let's go ahead, save that, refresh this. And you can still see the specularity and it's green. But let's go back here and change it. Instead of having it be green, let's have it be red. So we'll give it 100% red here by giving it the value of 1. And red and green, you may not realize this because you've been told different things in elementary school, but red and green do make yellow. That might seem weird because you think, well, yellow and blue make green, and basically, well, I'm not going to get into the whole bunch of color things. It's also, people think that 100% of color is black. You think you add more color in. That's not true. That's pigments. You have to think about additive colors and subtractive colors, and it can get a little confusing, but I do want to point out here, if we set all our values, oops, that should have been a 0, not a 0, we do that and we refresh, we got black because we removed all color from our light, meaning there is no light, there is no color, which is black. If I set all three values here, I'll refresh that and we get white. A pure white light. If we were to go 101, that would be 0 amount of green, and we would get red and blue, which will give us a purplish color, purplish pink. There you go. So don't get confused that, because red and green make yellow. And our specularity here is set to zero. So let's go ahead and play with this a little bit more. I'm going to set this back to zero here. And I'm just going to play around with this just a little bit. I'm going to put a variable in here. I'll call it LD. Let's create that variable. We'll create it right up here. I'll say var LD equals, and I'll say zero. And then I'm going to create another variable. I'll call it var LX, just to give it a name. I did LD for light diffused. LX is just L, light, in a variable. We'll say 0.01, I think, should be a good number. And so right now we're saying set the diffuse to 000. So everything is going to be black in our scene because the light is basically turned off. It has no color to it. But let's go ahead and play around with this. Let's go down to our rendering loop here. And what we're going to do here is we're going to create a little bit of an effect. We're going to have the light power go from off to bright red and then back off, and just kind of a pulsating light. So we're going to take the variable LD that we created, and we're going to say plus equals, so whatever it already equals, we're going to add to it LX, which we created, and we set to 0.01. And we're going to say, okay, every time the loop, the render renders again in loops, we're going to say, we'll change the diffuse. And we're going to say again, a new Babylon.color. Again, case sensitive here, capital C, 3. And we're going to keep the green and the blue at 0, but we'll set our red to change as that change. So right now, we'll start at black, and as it loops, it'll turn red, and the number keeps going up, but it's not going to go back down at this point. So let's go ahead and change this and add an if-then statement. So what we're going to do here is we're going to say if LD is greater than 1, let's change the value of LX to equal negative point, 0.1. And we'll say else if LD is less than 0, then we're going to change the LX to equal 0.01. Or, yeah, this should be a 0.1. Okay. So let's look over what we just wrote here. We already set a values for these two variables at the beginning. LD is 0, LX is 0.01. So here it's going to look. Is it less than 1? Well, right away it's not. It's set to 0. Is it less than 0? It's not. It is 0. So it's going to start looping, and it's going to add 0.01 every time it loops. At any point, if it gets over 1, we're going to flip that around to be a negative. So now it's actually going to be subtracting that value. And in this case, once it gets below 0, it's going to go back to adding the number. So we should get a pulsating light here. Pulsating red light. Well, there you go. And just for fun, let's see. We'll look at the other side of our objects here. You notice everything is black. You can see the red on the angles because the light's over there, but on this side everything's dark. Let's add a second point light and just make it a basic green one. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to copy two lines and I'm going to paste them right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to say, let's create a new light, call it light one, label it omni one. And instead of moving it forward, we'll move it back so it's on the other side of our objects. And here we're going to say light1.diffused. And we're just going to set it, let's just make it a simple green light. F5. There we go. We got our red light, starts off, pulsates on and off. And if we look at the other side of our objects, besides our plane, which is only visible from one side, you can see we got green on this side. And you do see that the colors do blend on our objects. So hopefully that wasn't too long. I didn't want it to be too short. We looked at scaling and rotating, positioning objects, throwing that stuff into loops, and then we worked a little bit with adding extra lights, colorizing them, and changing those colors on a periodic basis. I hope you found this tutorial useful. And again, I mean, you got all your basic shapes here, you got your basic lights. Be sure to come back next week, and there'll be another tutorial. If the tutorial is out, there should be, there will eventually be a playlist with all these. So I thank you for watching. Filmsbychris.com is my website. That's Chris with a K. Check out, there should be a link in the description. You can get all the code for all of these examples there through there on my GitHub page. Just click on codes, go to GitHub. I explained all that in the first tutorial. I thank you for watching, and I hope that you have a great day. I would like to take a moment to thank the following Patreon supporters for helping make this video possible.